Josh, this is Renee. Can you hear me?
I can.
Oh, okay. I didn't know if we were muted. Okay.
Well, we're going to start in just a minute. I'm going to give a little presentation slash speech, kind of talk about what this meeting is, because I don't want anyone to be confused about what this meeting specifically is. And then open for questions, comments, whatnot. And then I couldn't imagine this meeting actually going for an hour once you actually hear what this meeting's about. This is probably going to be a very short meeting. And then we'll see how it goes. It looks like I don't see anyone else trickling in, but if they do, I don't mind repeating this because, again, this isn't a big, long spiel or anything. So Board Regulation 7310, what is that? That is the naming of facility regulation. Of course, just as I start, somebody new comes in. That's okay. Starting again, Regulation 7310 is the naming of facilities. That was a board regulation that was passed. That was to help the district have some sort of system in place when a name is proposed for one of our facilities. And that facility can be a building, it can be a sports field, it can be, it's supposed to be something meaningful. We don't want to go out and start naming benches and, you know, things like that. It needs to be something meaningful. But there needed to be stipulations about how that process works. Well, this is part of that process. So what this meeting tonight is that we have in the regulation, it says that when somebody, the process is that when somebody that could be an SVUSD employee, alumni, parent, or any community member that has somebody or something to nominate a name for the existing, unnamed, or a new facility. When somebody has that, they have to go through the nomination process, and that nomination process is to provide the name and contact information of the nominator. I'm basically just reading this off of what the regulation says, but so we're all on the same page. Name and contact information of the nominator, name and contact information of the individual or geographic region that's being nominated, the years of service to the district and community for the person nominated, if applicable, the reason for the nomination, the contributions of that individual to the school district or community. Again, if you're calling it Dragon Stadium, you're not going to tell us why, you know, what Dragons have done for us, but, you know, it needs to be within reason. A letter from the family or descendants of the individual giving their consent to use of their name. And then 100 signatures in support of the nomination from community members that demonstrate a cross-section of the community. That's the one that's probably the most nebulous in there. What we take that is that if you know, all 100 signatures came from, I'm just giving an example here, the Boy Scouts, that's one collective group. We probably want to see 100 signatures, you know, 50 of them could come from the Boy Scouts. That's fine. But the other 50 should probably be coming from other places within the community, giving us a good, what they call in here, a cross-section of the community. Once that happens, the person will submit that nomination to Kira. She's not named in here. Her position is. She is our executive assistant to the superintendent. She's named in here. So you would turn the packet into her. When that happens, this meeting is triggered, and that's where we are tonight. So far we've received one nomination that has followed this formal process, and that nomination is currently for the field to be the SVHS, so Sonoma Valley High School athletic field, the space that is inside of, in this letter, Chance Track. We're still trying to work through that very nebulous piece of this whole thing. To have Midgley Field be the name, named after Robert Bob Midgley Jr. So that is the nomination that we've received. So what is this meeting tonight? Well, this meeting is, what's listed here is that once the signatures have been confirmed, the naming committee will hold two public meetings. The first one is to announce the nomination and solicit any additional nominations. That's all we're doing here tonight. So I've now announced that we've received a nomination, and the solicitation is to say that we are the naming committee will now be looking at names for the SVHS athletic field, the place, the football and soccer, and there's other games played there, but we know it mostly as the football and soccer field that is inside the track at the high school. Dennis is like, Josh, stop calling it a football and soccer field. It's got other, I know, I'm sorry. But for the people who aren't PE teachers, they kind of think of it as football and soccer. That's really all we are here to do today. So I hope, number one, what I don't want to do is make anyone feel like they can't be heard, but also the entire committee's not here, number one. Number two, the committee will review this nomination and any other nominations collectively. So we're not going to review one and then another and then another. We'll review them all together. And then we bring a recommendation based on those nominations. We do not create our own or anything like that. We bring a recommendation based on those nominations to the board. And the board is the one who votes. So if there's any sort of things like I'm seeing, you know, family members to the person that is nominated here. You know, thank you very much for coming. If you want to lobby for that kind of thing, it's to the board that you want to lobby that to. Just FYI. And number two, I guess I should say the date. We have 6 months from the time that this was submitted. Now, Renee was kind enough to make this submission here. We did that. Can't remember if it's the first week or second week of December. I don't think that that's going to end up mattering at the end. We're not going to take 6 months to go through this whole thing. But it'd be 6 months from then. So we can call it 6 months from the first week of December. So we'll get it done even sooner. What I've discussed with the board at the last board meeting, if you heard during the presentation where I announced this meeting, I said that would it be fair to give people 45 days to go and collect 100 signatures if they were going to offer a competing nomination? That would be a nomination for the same place, right? If somebody wanted to name a softball field, that is a different one. And that would actually trigger this meeting again for a new nomination. So we're just talking about this nomination. This nomination, 45 days for another nomination to come in for the SVHS athletic field. So wanted to see exactly where that put us. Had this pulled up before and then my calendar closed and I lost my space. But if we said 45 days from there, 17th would be 37. So that would be on March 3rd. So we would have to, by March 3rd, have the other nomination. I see your hand, Renee. I'll call you in just a second. The final part of this. So then what happens? After we have either received other or none, right? It's on the 45th day. We will be scheduling, well, we probably already have it scheduled, but there will be scheduled a meeting of the naming committee to then sit and discuss all the nominations. From that, there is a second meeting that is a publicly held meeting. And in that case here, it says that the dates, a second one to receive feedback on the names that the committee is considering. So that would also be a time where you could talk to the committee themselves and say what you know, how you feel, what you believe, so on and so forth, before going to the board. But I do want to remind everyone here that this committee will not make a decision. They will just make a recommendation, or I guess lack thereof, if they were to come to no agreement, either a recommendation or lack thereof. The board is the one who actually votes to decide if we will name something or not. So, Renee, do you have the ability to unmute yourself?
I do. My question was, you mentioned there's 45 days from today, and I thought that it was 30, but I don't know why I thought that. Is 45 in the process document, the new the board policy?
The process document actually does not say a date. It just says that we will solicit any additional nominations. One of the problems that we sort of, when I was talking to the board and ran into, is that, well, what happens if we bring a nomination? And I'm not saying this is going to happen or anything, but let's say we bring a nomination and we recommend it to the board. And we say, well, it was recommended with an 8-3 vote or something like that. I don't know. Just say that happens. And then somebody else brings another one. And then somebody else brings another one. Do we have to go back and do the same process again? Does it restart? So we said, let's pick a time frame that seems fair. And the board agreed that 45 days seemed fair. If you couldn't get 100 signatures in 45 days, then you probably don't have the support for that name that we would need to permanently name something in our community. So 45 days to do that, and then the committee will have all of its information at once so that we can deliberate and discuss all at once rather than having it piecemealed out.
That makes sense. Thank you. Just in my head, it was 30 somewhere. Maybe it was said somewhere, but I appreciate that it went through the process to determine a length of time to be finite.
Yeah, no problem. So from there, of course, take any questions that you may have. We do have some committee members in the audience here as well. I guess I can go quickly around and introduce you all with Leslie McLean, Dennis Hausman, Richard Smith. Let's see, is anyone else on here? I am the, I didn't even introduce myself to the people that don't know. My name is Joshua Braff. I'm the Associate Superintendent of Business Services for the district. I am the administrator, the district office administrator. I have talked with the board about what my role is on this committee, and we came to an agreement on that as well, that I should act more as a facilitator. So I make sure that the meetings run, collect information, bring information to the committee, but I most likely will not have a vote on anything. The board was a little not 100% sure on how they felt about that, but I kind of feel like being the facilitator means that I probably shouldn't have an ending vote on something. It puts too much power in one bucket for a community committee. But other than that, I mean, if no one has any questions, we can all log off. This is our first time doing this meeting, so we didn't know like what it was going to turn out to be like, what it was going to look like, everything like that. I'm happy that even so many people showed up that shows interest in the naming of our facilities. That's great. I thought I was going to be sitting here by myself. So
I do have one more question, Josh. You mentioned that the family could indicate to the board their desire, but anyone could, right?
Anyone, of course, anyone could. Okay. Two times. There's two opportunities. There will be a second public meeting of the naming committee per the regulation that it says we will ask for community input. So there's one time that family, friends, anyone who has a feeling, and that's pro or against, right? Like, it's going to be open to everyone, can come and, respectfully add to the conversation.
Meeting number two, right?
At meeting number two.
Yeah. Which will be after March 3rd, after the 45 days.
Correct. And it will be a public meeting. And then the other time would be when we go to present this to the board as either a nomination or non-nomination. I don't know what to call it, but we're going to present something to the board. That would be the other time, because then you're actually talking to the board about their vote, right? So the committee, we have our role, but our role is not to name something. Our role is to, to vet, to deliberate between different names, that type of thing. The board is who actually names something. So I just want everyone to know that you will have an opportunity to participate in that. This is not what all the meetings are like. This is just what the first meeting is like. All right. I know you all love just looking at me here, but I think we can go if nobody has any other questions. Well, thank you very much, Renee, for getting this process started. Thank you all for participating in this process. We greatly appreciate it. I know that it's a little confusing, but that's, you know, that's we're working out the kinks, working out the wrinkles of a new process, and it'll only get better by people participating in it. So thank you all very much for coming. And we'll close the meeting here.
Have a good night.
Bye, everyone.